Hi, today I want to show you this small parcel from the local eBay. It took about a week to arrive. Okay, it's very simple, packed in plastic bag. It's a video capture. And here are a video, an audio, and a S video. And here goes to USB. The USB tension cable is included. And there's a CD included, although my laptop hasn't got a CD drive. I bought this one, it's showing Windows 10 is supported. I hope that's true. And there's an instruction here. Actually, I already got one. I bought this one long time ago. It was saying support Windows 7 64-bit. And when I tried it out, it didn't work for Windows 7. I was only able to run it on XP. So, this is my Siemens SVHS video recorder. And I've connected the S-video output to the dongle and the audio here. And this is the software, so let's try it. The video is running and I can hear the sound. I've just found out I need to go to setting here and change the video device to the USB 2. Then I can see the image. I'm using OBS software. The software came with the dongle, didn't work properly, most of the time didn't work, I could get it work sometime. The image is okay, nothing wrong. And now I'm trying with the home video, which has been recorded on SVHC from a camcorder and copied to a SVHS large size tape. And you can see it's not doing well. I ended up getting my old dongle to work, and now this one is connected to SVHS, and I'm using the OBS software. As you can see, the image is stable, nothing wrong. Only the setup of the OBS took a little bit longer. There's a lot of experimental stuff. So, I've tested the easier cap only with the S signal. This is not really a review. I didn't test the composite signal. As you can see, it works with SVHS, but only with the good quality tape, which has a recording from a TV program. And the software is very bad. Most of the time I couldn't get it work. When I got it work, the preview is not smooth. And I also noticed one thing, composite and SVHS is disabled, so I guess this can identify the signal automatically. Unfortunately, maybe that's also the problem of it. When the tape is not good enough, then the software got confused. If I compare to the old one, the software is very similar. You can see the panel of composite and SVHS is enabled, so I could choose it manually. And also I could select all the different type of TV system like NTSC, SATCOM, PAL, and all different type of PAL system. At the moment, I'm happy that I could get this work, which wasn't working before I bought this one. Somehow when I tried to install all different driver from internet, and I never got it work on Windows 7 or Windows 10. My whole point is just to get my home video over to the computer, so it doesn't matter whether I use this or use that. I hope you find this video useful. If you like it, please give me a thumb up. Thank you for watching. Bye.